What's up, guys? Welcome to Daily Dose of Reddit. This is your host, Zach, and today's subreddit is r/pro-revenge. Okay, so some of you OGs, I mean, not really OGs, but yeah, if some of you have been here for a while probably remember or recognize the name Fabulous Lil Queen. Well, we have another story from them about his revenge against his entitled aunt. So it's called Threaten and Harass Me? I'll get you shunned by your church, stop your free holidays, and make you face reality! Finally got my revenge. Revenge on my entitled aunt. Hello, cherubs. I originally posted this in r/pro-revenge, but was told it doesn't count as pro-revenge. So I posted on Reddit a fair few times about my entitled aunt. She is not a very nice person, and she actively goes out of her way to make other people miserable. In the past month or so, my entitled aunt, let's just call her Karen for the sake of the story, got in touch with me after a good and peaceful few years without talking to me or any of my family. Though it was only to demand that I drive her and my entitled cousin, we'll call her Regina, like the biatch from Mean Girls, to a church thing that one of the church members was holding. I'm still not entirely sure what the meeting was for, but my best guess is that it was to sort out the donated food for the food bank delivery thing that the church wanted to set up. Karen, however, didn't care about the food bank as it required helping others, but was instead interested in me driving them there so they could discuss with Pastor Smith, not his real name, about getting Regina baptized. I declined as I wasn't sure about the restrictions with diving and stuff, especially considering Karen lives around an hour or more away from me. Also, she's not a nice person and I just didn't want to be around her. This led to her harassing me, posting absolutely horrific Facebook posts about me. I don't even want to repeat half the things they said in those posts. She called and messaged me paragraphs filled with vile, homophobic, and transphobic slurs, and a crap load of grammar mistakes. For some context, I am a gay drag queen, currently living with my boyfriend, and Karen absolutely hates me for it. She often tries to use religion to justify her hatred of me, but she has actively admitted in the past that she does not believe in God's existence. Nothing against religious people. If you're religious, then go on and live your best life, honey. But Karen only seems to be religious when it benefits her. A couple of weeks ago, the harassment finally got to me. I broke down in tears and had my first full-on panic attack in almost a year. The situation had caused my boyfriend, Andy, not his real name, and I to start arguing. Not a lot, but we'd have days where he'd get sick of me just letting her talk to me like that and would practically beg me to do something to put an end to this. When I'm in drag, I tend to be a lot more outgoing, confident, and, catty, and would have no issue shutting Karen and her hellspawn down. But out of drag, I am a completely different person, much more timid and not fond of confrontation. After a while of Andy calming me down and just cuddling and crying for a little while, I finally decided to do something about this. But calling the police to give her a warning or restraining order, whilst necessary at this point, did not seem like a big enough punishment for her. So I started planning. I decided to gather as much evidence as I could. I decided to screenshot the messages and Facebook posts and put them in a nice little folder to send to her church. I also sent a message to one of the ladies in her church with some screenshots of the transphobic stuff she'd said and posted. See, Karen has two Facebook profiles. One for pretending that she's the perfect Christian mom, and the other was specifically for spreading hate. Not very Christian-like. She had posted a bunch of vile things about how transphobic slurs should be wiped out, which I think we can all agree is pretty awful. That's also a more tame part of one of her posts. They practically borderline on death threats, but I'm not even gonna repeat them here. The reason for sending these to a lady in Karen's church? The lady's daughter came out a few months ago as a trans woman. Karen acts all friendly with the lady's daughter, though, because she's been on a few almost free holidays with this lady. The lady was generous enough to pay for Karen and Regina to go on holiday with her and her family after Karen made out that she felt guilty for not being able to afford to take Regina on holiday. Bullcrap, honey. Karen is a benefit sheet. She gets, or got, but that's for another paragraph, over $250 a week from Regina's dad in child support, and my dad, scumbag, would help her buy groceries and put money towards other bills for her. She had more money than most people that work do. Nothing against people on benefits, by the way. Everyone needs help sometimes. Anyway, sorry for rambling. I sent these screenshots to the lady from Karen's church, and she was not happy, to say the least. I sent a message saying that this was the kind of stuff that Karen believed, and that I was concerned for her daughter's safety due to the sheer severity of some of the insults and posts. She thanked me for the information and said she was going to have a word with some of the other church members. I was genuinely worried that this lady's daughter could get hurt though, so I kinda killed two birds with one stone. From what the lady told me, and the angry messages from Karen and Regina, the two of them are no longer welcome on the holiday that the lady's family was planning for after lockdown. No free holiday? Shame. Her church has not been a fan of her behavior. Apparently, she had not been showing up to any church events before the virus, unless it benefited her. She did not want to help with soup kitchens or food banks, but she'd show up if they were giving away free stuff. Pastor Smith actually reached out to me to apologize on my aunt's behalf for all the trouble she's caused us. The church is very relaxed about LGBT issues and just believes in spreading love and helping those in need, which I can totally get behind. I'm not sure whether she had an argument with the members of her church, but the lady I messaged did tell me that she told a few of the members to step off, so I don't think she was happy. She isn't welcome in the church while she acts like this. Though they have told her that she will be welcomed back with open arms after she finds a healthy way to deal with all her hate. The church did not feel good about asking her to leave, apparently, but she was reportedly rude to the other members of the church and made them uncomfortable, so they didn't have a choice. They actually recommended a few therapists for Karen and maybe Regina to talk to and deal with their anger, which I thought was a nice gesture, and I seriously hope they do see a therapist. Anyway, the lady I contacted actually got in contact with Regina's dad about everything that happened. He was livid. Regina's dad is an absolutely lovely man. He cares about his daughter so much, and it makes me kinda angry that she doesn't appreciate him. I'd kill to have a dad that cared about me. She freaked out with him when she was 15 because he got her the wrong iPhone. Like, seriously? He was paying all this money for child support. I call it child support, but it's really just to help Regina out since she doesn't have a job and is like almost 20. He had also been helping with bills and food, etc., as Karen was making out that she couldn't afford anything. This saint, even paid for these two to go on holiday. Karen told him she paid for the free holidays they went on with this lady, when they actually just wasted it on the most materialistic crap. I honestly felt really bad for the guy. He has a well-paid job, but that's beside the point. He still pays for these two to do nothing and supports his new wife and their 12-year-old boy. You can imagine my surprise when I found out that he'd actually reported her for being a benefits cheat. I'm not sure how it's going as of right now, but hopefully I'll have the details for y'all and I'll add them here in an update. I hope her benefits get stopped and both of them have to get a job. There is no reason either of them can't work. They just don't want to deal with people. Yeah, woman, I hope reality hits you like a ton of bricks. I also did contact the police and have been advised, due to the severity of some of the threats, to file a restraining order, which I plan on doing. Anyway, I'm sorry for the long story. Hope y'all are having a good lockdown and staying safe, my cherubs. Okay, well, first of all, fabulous little queen, thank you for another amazing story. You're Your aunt is a special kind of crazy, and I'm so glad you put a stop to her antics, or at least tried to. And I'm curious, can therapy help with racism and stuff like that? Because I guess all that hatred has to be coming from something, right? And maybe it's just displaced, and they can find the root of their hatred, and then all of a sudden they're nice people, because they're directing their hatred towards something good. I mean, not good, but like something that deserves that energy. You get what I'm saying. But that church sounds like a really cool church. The fact that they're not just, you know, banning her outright, even though that she's saying some horribly disgusting things. So you gotta appreciate an organized religion factory actually using their influence for spreading a good message. I'm not saying religion's a bad message. I'm talking about those Westboro Baptist peeps. Alright, this story's called Shady Boss Lady. A few years ago, I was employed at a liquor store chain, and my specific store was managed by a terrible freaking human being. The only way I can describe her is as being a troll of a woman. She was inappropriate and offensive to all senses. She contradicted herself to make up for her incompetence. She yelled at me once for not being racist enough because I wasn't vigilant enough towards the young black kids who came through our doors. Well, one day the assistant manager said he had been documenting her hours clocked into pay system versus the actual time she spent at the store. Since our store was equipped with 6 cameras that were used by her on a daily basis to place blame on staff for searching the web while on clock, being on cell phones, not locking the back door during cigarette breaks, forgetting to mop store at the end of shift, etc. It was easy to prove that she had decided for the past few months to just coast with no intention of receiving a paycheck that reflected this. After she clocked in for 8 hours on Thanksgiving, she was there for maybe 1 hour, I didn't even see her and I worked midday to night shift, we decided to take care of business. We notified the chain's owners and the next day, I showed up to find one of the owners working the store and talking to customers. Turns out, he had been there since we opened that day to confront her face to face. My coworker said she was so taken aback that she was speechless, and the owner told her to grab her crap. She was done. The following month was filled with customer questions about our bimbo boss, and with smiles, we told everyone how she was stealing from the company. Sadly, last I heard, she opened up a daycare. Those poor kids, man. Wow! What a freaking Karen. Good thing she was fired, but those poor kids, man. This story's called Rob My Best Friend and Kick Him Out of His House? Prepare for revenge, mother lover, courtesy of the untouchable little brother. Some years back, one of my best friends, a true brother from another mother, had moved in with some mutual friends of my older sisters, of whom I was definitely not a fan. My buddy had just gotten access to a trust fund and they were using him. He bought them all new shoes and clothes, tickets to a music festival, all kinds of weed and paraphernalia, a new TV and console, you know, the responsible things you do with a trust fund. Definitely don't go to college. Really, you should though. Eventually, the trust fund ran out, and by eventually, I mean within a month and a half of him moving in with these buttholes. I'm sure you can guess what happened. All of his good gestures were for naught. They kicked him out immediately, but not before they took a bunch of brand new expensive bongs, confiscated a quarter pound of premium weed from him for not having rent money on hand when they asked for it. All the food he had bought for them, his Xbox and games, plus $150. Did I mention that the owner of the house and landlord was one of these guys' dads? No, I didn't think so. My buddy didn't know that either. Time for revenge, you thick-headed bastards! I know everything. They always left their back door unlocked. They wouldn't expect my buddy to have the balls, but guess what? My older sister is fortunately crazier than both of you. I do have the balls, and Chappelle taught me to plead the fifth. Yet you're writing about it. My buddy and I break in while they're at work a few days later as he assures me they have no security cameras. Know what they do have? Guitar Hero. Left on before these posers shuffled off to work. He shows me where their lockbox is. Just like Guitar Hero, it's amateur hour. My sister's diary had a more complicated lock. We break it open to discover around $1,200 in cash, an ounce or two of weed, a hippie crystal that looked valuable, I don't know, still mine now, and, totally off-kilter, a .38 revolver. We bag it all up, grab my buddy's bong, plus their last case of beer, and I start myself a bath that I'm never going to take. Buddy says he still wants his Xbox, though. Nah, son, I have a better idea. I spotted a grinder, a pipe, and Guitar Hero. We'll buy you a new one with this cash. We smash some beers, smoke the last of their weed, and leave with Bon Jovi's Living on a Prayer at 100% completion while the bath I started begins to flood the house. Now that's some good revenge, but I think it's more nuclear because, there's some B&E going. Or I guess not B&E. Unlawful entry going. There's some stealing, smoking, and thieving, and thrashing, and smashing, and clashing, and all that dashing. Anyway, yes, good revenge though. Good, what a good friend. I wish I had a friend that would revenge steal with me. Not that I would do that, but I wish I had a friend that would. Don't hit me up with offers to steal things with me, because I might accept it and I don't want to get in trouble right now. Alright, this story's called Cheat on Me and No One Goes on Vacation. My ex and I used to go to a Cancun resort every year with a bunch of our mutual friends. I found out my ex was cheating on me when I accidentally got a flight confirmation email that he booked tickets for himself and the other girl. It was rough. Tried to have a civil breakup, but he refused to pay me for the Cancun vacation that I had already prepaid. I tried to get my money back, but he refused. After our breakup, it took me several weeks to find a new place to live and move my things out of his house. On the last trip to the house, I asked him one last time for the money, and he again refused. So, I accidentally packed his current passport in my last box of things and left my expired passport in its place. Since he has already booked me the tickets, he apparently didn't check the passport until he was at the airport and was denied the international flight because he didn't have a current passport. I never did get my money, but I did get immense satisfaction that he didn't get to go on vacation. Update: I gave the passport back a couple of weeks later when I discovered it in a box of things to unpack. So weird, right? He asked for a refund for the flights, and I told him I would be happy to if he refunded me for the resort, which was more expensive. He declined. Moral of the story? Don't cheat. That sucks. Anyway, good job. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that bell to never miss an episode.